Data, performance, and culture. Is there a correlation beyond what is obvious to us? Welcome to Thank God It's a Story Saturday, a weekly video series where I share stories with you that you can use to make your messages stick. Today's story is from this book called Smarter, Faster, Better. I read this book, I think, in the year 2015, which is the year that it came out. The story is about Amy Edmondson. The year is 1991. Amy is studying organizational behavior at Harvard. Her professor asks her to go and observe medical errors in the hospital environment. She chooses two hospitals in Boston to go and make that observation. She talks to the nurses, she looks at the files in which the errors are logged, and she just generally has conversation with people who are working in these wards. What she starts to very quickly notice is that, shockingly, there is a lot of mistakes that are made in these wards. For example, a nurse who is meant to give an IV of lidocaine, which is an anesthetic, ends up giving the IV of heparin, which is a blood thinner. Now, there's plenty of such mistakes made, not because there's lack of competence in that environment, but because the hospital environment is very complex. You work in large team. To give you an understanding of that, one patient can have 24 people working on this patient, which would include techs, doctors, nurses, etc. So obviously the opportunities to make mistakes increase. She then starts to observe the patterns in the mistakes and the wards that these mistakes are coming from. For example, she notices that in orthopedic ward, the number of mistakes that are made is roughly about 1 in 3 weeks, but in cardiac ward, every week there is a mistake made. She then shifts her focus to the culture of these wards. She starts to notice, how do people work in these wards? And she notices a clear difference. For example, in cardiac ward, she sees that the nurses are really friendly, informal, chatty. They stop in the hallways and chit-chat to each other. Their working areas is filled with their family photos, etc. Wherein the orthopedic ward nurses are very different. They keep to themselves. Their working areas are very clean and clutter-free. So she starts to think that maybe if she tries to find out about the culture of each working team and see if there is a correlation with that in the errors made in each ward, she'll find something. She does the survey, a culture survey, like many of us do, and she puts the typical questions that we all put: happiness, satisfaction, clear strategy, communication, and she gets the results. When she gets the results, she's pretty sure what's going to happen is that the teams that have a better working culture will make less mistakes, which is what we all think. So she tabulates the results, and the results do not match to what she thought they would. The teams that had poor culture actually made less mistakes, and the teams that had good culture made more mistakes. She was confused. So she started looking at every single question that was there in the survey. And there's this one question that points her to the right direction. The question is, are you personally held responsible for the mistake you make in this ward? When she looks at that question and the results she'd gotten for that, what she realizes is that it's not that the teams that have poor culture are the teams that make less mistakes. Is that they report less mistakes, and teams that have a better culture and good rapport with each other are very comfortable with reporting every error made, because to them the end goal is patient welfare. Now, what is the point? The point of this story is this: in this environment, which is a new environment where we're having to find new barometers of success of the team, turning up to a Zoom call, presenting whatever you say, etc., are not the right ways to be able to get the best out of the team. Your team will not perform unless they have a better culture. And even if the data does not point you to that direction, you have to question that data. So the performance metrics are quite often dependent on what kind of team relationship there is.